Peace and love, family. It's your host, Taylor, with the Prophetic Truth. Back with a different type of video today. We're going to be doing a reaction video, actually, to some content that I saw floating around the internet around a YouTube channel called Salary Transparent. And I think this is really relevant for our situation and for our people within the tech space, or whether you're in the business, marketing, things of that nature. This is a perfect opportunity to kind of understand what's out there in terms of salary, benefits, and maneuvering throughout your career. Me personally, I've been within the IT space coming up on 6 years. I'm a network operations manager, so I have the privilege of engaging and leading a team, and we maintain and support the backbone of a network. So this video is really, you know, insightful to try to get a better understanding of what type of careers lie within the tech space and where does the salary maybe complement that career. So let's tune in and see what we have. And just to let you know, this is the first for me. Like, I haven't seen this video yet, so really interested to see how these salaries are measuring up. Let's get into it.
How long have you been doing this?
5 years now.
How much do you make? Do you feel really compensated? What kind of college degree did you have? Like, was that a real prerequisite? Was it necessary?
Yeah, I mean, I would say a college degree was necessary. I mean, I have a bachelor's in information technology, but I went to school online the entire time. It definitely opened the door.
What are some other pros and cons of your job?
Pros are it's like remote. I don't really have to go anywhere. It's really good. Some cons are like a lot of my favorites are Indian, so it's like time difference, meeting a lot. Sometimes it gets a little stressful.
What pieces of advice do you have for anyone interested in tech, cybersecurity, anything to add?
Like, just get into cybersecurity. I preach it like it's the gospel. Certifications are huge. You get a degree and a certification, you're golden.
Do you know what the career progression looks like in your role? Like, how high does it go? Like, what could be so possible? Yeah. Like, what does the future hold?
You can go up to management. You can be like a CISM, which is a certified information security manager. You can make upwards to 300, 500K bonuses. And never stop.
Come on now. So we're here looking at, you know, a brother who is in cybersecurity, right? And he's telling you that this level of entry into this space, you can do so without a degree. It's just certification based. And in his perspective, right, or his role, he's a cybersecurity analyst, and he make around or at 150. And, you know, for me, if I'm looking at that, you know, he may be in his early 30s, right? And to be making 150, that's, just put that in perspective in terms of what your parents may have made, or what your parents' parents may have made, right? A lot of people don't even see that through the course of their work career. To be able to make that just based off of a certification or a little bit of, you know, programming and understanding what this market holds for you is really beneficial. And I think we should all tap into other ways and skills that we can use that can be transferable. So really insightful to see. Cybersecurity analyst, not even in management. Like, I'm in management, right? And, you know, 150 is, you know, man, it's crazy.
I have my own designer vintage store. How did you get into vintage? I was selling on Depop during college time, and then I graduated during the pandemic, so it was super difficult to find a job. And so I was like, you know what? This is my opportunity to really go after what I want to do. How much do you make doing what you do? I actually just did my taxes, so I have an exact number. I made $83,000. I get to do what I love, so I never thought I'd be able to make this like a living and do it full time. How were you able to turn this into a business? I think just being authentic to myself and posting on Instagram, I realized a lot of businesses sometimes don't connect with their customers. And so really putting a face to who I was and what I believed in, I was able to find people that also are really passionate about sustainability and all that. What are some of the pros and cons of your role?
Pro
pros is being creative and getting to kind of experiment with different things. Yeah. Cons would be the fact that you have to take on a lot of roles, and it sometimes feels like you don't really have a day off. Because
so, you know, I love this, you know, transparency that she's given as an entrepreneur and as a business owner. A lot of people think like, oh, if I own a business, or hey, I don't want to work for no one, but don't know what it really takes, you know. And what I mean by don't know what it really takes, who did you sit around, right? What business owner do you know of that you engaged with and really took the time to sit around and learn from? And a lot of us, in terms of, you know, whether you're a millennial, whether you're Gen Z, Gen X, whatever the gen is, right? We become stubborn, and you know, we're led by our ego, and that can keep you out of the rooms. That's really just that opportunity for you to reach to that level that you're trying to reach. So as she said, she saw opportunity in COVID, and with that led to her starting her own business and taking a risk. Did she know she was going to be able to make money? Not, absolutely not. But she also had a plan in place to ensure that it was just that much more guaranteed, right? Or just that much fail proof that she could execute this vision that she had for herself. So, you know, I encourage people to ask questions. It's a lot of people that I talk to are graduating and don't really know what they want to do. And then they get stuck and feeling like I have to do this to make it, because so many people are depending on me. But I think at the same time, you got to be true and authentic, as she mentioned. You got to be true and authentic to yourself to really understand, what am I really here to do, and what aspect can I do it? Who do I need help from? Who can I go shadow to see how do they run a business, and all the many hats that they have to wear? Because she said it, like she said, I got to wear all these hats. And a lot of people just look at the outside and think that, oh man, I just want this because it's so cool and it sounds so cool, and not even willing to put in the work. Some people don't even want to do simple stuff. So the simple stuff, like asking questions and being willing to learn and be coachable, is so important when you're on that path to entrepreneurship and in that path in life in general. So keep that in mind.
What pieces of advice would you share with anyone interested in being an entrepreneur? What have you learned so far? Definitely don't let people pass on their limiting beliefs onto you. When I first wanted to start this business, I had a close friend tell me that I wasn't going to be able to make money doing it, that it's just something that works. And sometimes people don't mean it in a way of harm. They're just trying to look out for you. But if you believe in yourself, your dreams and your goals, then you should still go for it anyway.
I do content strategy and presidential.
And how much do you make doing what you do?
7 years. Okay.
You feel really compensated?
I do, yeah.
How long have you been doing it?
2 years with this particular job, but overall, 5 or 6 years.
What's your favorite platform to use?
I go between TikTok and Instagram a lot. I think community-wise, TikTok has a really good leverage there. Kind of just that piece. So more familiar with different topics and things similar to you, but I do think Instagram.
What are the pros and cons of your job?
I'd say for sure, kind of always being on the clock. So just kind of being prepared for that. Definitely having time management skills is definitely helpful. So kind of just able to prioritize, predict a lot. You won't have that much stress.
If you could describe your role in one sentence, what would you say?
Ever changing. It's just flexible. It's never the same day. So I do love that. I keep you on your toes. You
What are some pieces of advice you share for anyone who wants to work in your industry, or what have you learned?
I think the most important thing that I've learned is always seeing what you can take away from the experience, what content that you're building out, and seeing how you can improve for next time. Not being too hard on yourself, but it's never going to be perfect. But if you have that consistency, you're perfect.
I am a building automation systems recruiter.
How much do you make?
I make $3,750 a month base, but uncapped commission.
Do you feel fairly compensated?
Absolutely.
How long have you been doing this?
About 8 months.
Is that total experience? Like, how did you get into the role?
I've always enjoyed talking to recruiters. They were great in finding me positions, and I was always grateful, and now I want to give back and do the same thing for others.
What are some of the pros and cons of your role?
Pros, you get to speak with a lot of people on a day-to-day basis. You negotiate contracts. You find out about salary. Salary is a motivator for most people, so you definitely get to be part of that and help them out as well. Everybody wins.
So pay transparency is important to you as a recruiter?
Oh, absolutely. It's important to my client and the candidates I represent as well.
What piece of advice would you have for anyone who's interested in doing your role and would help you grow?
Persistent. Always be persistent. It's a sales job. So always make the calls, follow up with your candidates, follow up with your clients. Start early, work hard, and persistence, persistence, and persistence.
And that's a good point. As he mentioned, like he's saying persistence, persistence, persistence. And a lot of people say, oh man, I am persistent. But sometimes we're only persistent when we want to be persistent. So it's important to remember. The other girl was making, you know, young lady was making 78 grand. And the sister was saying, all right, I feel compensated. Right. And keep in mind, like the average income in America, annual household income is 75,000. So when people think, oh, man, I want to make, you know, $150,000 and all this other stuff. I mean, it's definitely possible. And I believe that you can do so. But understand you have to start from somewhere. And don't get discouraged that you're not making that right out the gate because you just graduated yesterday. Like, you got to keep it in perspective. So he said uncapped commission. He's a recruiter. He connects people that's looking for jobs, basically, and getting them, you know, hired or whatever. And he's getting an uncapped commission for the base of $3,750 a month. Pretty good. So sure he can. Sure, he can max that out, and I'm sure he's getting pretty good salary there.
I'm a senior web designer.
How much do you make?
I make 175.
How long have you been doing it?
5 years. I graduated in.
Do you feel fairly compensated?
I am underpaid. So based on my market research, I should be closer to about 220 to 230. I can't complain, but you got to get what you're worth in the market.
What are some of the pros and cons of your job?
Fully remote. I haven't been to the office in 3 years. It's pretty straightforward, but it depends on if you like coding or not. I love coding. I've been doing it since I was 5. It's not crazy challenging. Good work-life balance. I never work more than 40 hours a week, but you don't get overtime. So sometimes when you do, you're on salary. You just got to put in that work. You learn a lot of job availability. I can basically pivot anywhere and go to any company. It's a lot of fun, but some days it will just drive you crazy. Like you're trying to debug something, like in the code, and you just have to work for hours and hours and hours. There's no obvious solution, and you just got to beat your head against the wall until you figure it out.
What pieces of advice did you get for anyone interested in doing your role? Like, what helped you get into it?
So I did get a bachelor's degree in computer science at Penn State, but you don't need a degree to do a lot of this stuff. I think it can get you in the door a bit. You can learn all this stuff yourself for free online. I learned 80% of everything I know just on my own at home, playing around, writing games.
Licensed customer service associate.
How long have you been doing that?
A year.
How much do you make?
About $55,000.
Do you feel fairly compensated?
Maybe, I don't know. Because it depends on how busy the call center.
How is your job? Like, what are some of the favorite things that you like to do?
It was very, very busy with back-to-back calls. Very hard. But they do care, I guess, because they did hire more people. And so now the calls haven't been my full back-to-back. So it's been positive that it looks like it.
What pieces of advice do you have for anyone interested in your role? Like, what have you learned?
The way I found this job was through a Facebook job group. So just be applying to different places and just to enjoy talking with people, and it's a remote job.
Do you have, like, any funny stories doing customer care?
I mostly work with people over 65. They have, their personality, but then sometimes they are some kind of rude people. So it's a balance.
How long have you been doing it?
For 2 years.
How much do you make?
It varies. My first year, because the market was really good, I made 150, but then this year, or just last year, is 80. The economy is different, but I think that's the biggest key. What I really love about you guys is everybody needs to prioritize and manage their money well.
What pieces of advice, as someone who works in finance, would you have for people to get started in that?
Just understand where your money goes. That's the biggest thing. Working with a banker or just getting educated is very key.
What are some of the pros and cons of your role?
I understand my money better because now I understand a lot of other people's budgets.
What piece advice would you share with anyone interested in also working in your industry or just career advice in general?
Definitely from my own interviews, trying to find mentorship in the banking finance world, because in 2020 when the pandemic happened, I got laid off because I was working at a gym. All gyms were closed. But luckily, my cousin ended up being the office manager for a mortgage company. Yeah, it's about networking, meeting cool people like you.
I'm a graduate research assistant.
So, I mean, I definitely understand what the last two people said, but one thing that stood out to me was really just the variation, right? And I really, that's why I really like salary transparent. And this is, it looks like she was here interviewing in the DMV area down in DC. So that's really cool, but it gave you a perspective of what people are making and what they're doing. So the one guy two interviews ago said, hey, I'm a web designer, whatever, making 175, right? And then the next person go on and says she's making, 55. And then someone else comes up and says he's making, as a loan officer, the guy, you know, right before him, said I'm making, you know, around 80, and at the when it's good, I'm making around 150. And it's just interesting, the spectrum of one, the money and how it works, but how these different skills put you in these different positions. So just keep that in mind in terms of how you're thinking about your money, and what your aspirations are, and where do you want to earn? Like, where do you want to put in the work to earn the maximum amount you can? Because it's definitely going to be some work. But if you really want to make, you know, the 175 and understand what that entails, then it's definitely possible for you to do so. So don't be afraid to network with those people. It's a huge spectrum. And this gives you a good idea of what they're paying. Because a lot of these people sound like they got some good experience.
How much do you make doing what you do?
I make 30K per year.
Do you feel fairly compensated?
I'm satisfied with my current salary, but I like being researched.
What are you researching?
I'm researching in the area of disaster resilience. My degree is civil engineering.
What's your favorite thing about your role?
My favorite thing about my role is that I connect to many scholars, and also I connect to young generation, and also I'm updated with new ideas in my field.
What are some of the cons of your role?
Cons of my role is, I think it's a lot of uncertainty and also stress too. It's not work-life balance.
What are some pieces of advice?
Kind of confused. So he said he has a degree in civil engineering. And I believe on average that civil engineer on average is going to make, I know they're making more than 30. So I'm just trying to understand. Maybe he's in school, you know, maybe he's in school getting his master's or something, and he's a research assistant for that, or he has an internship and that's his internship. I'm not entirely certain, but it's hard. It's very hard to live off 30K. So I'm not sure if that's a job or that's a internship of some sort of apprenticeship, because that's a lot of effort to go get a civil engineering degree. So, but it's perspective.
For others interested in research or in your role in general,
my advice is that to connect to other fellow graduate research assistants and also have a mentor, have a good connection with your advisor.
I'm a video marketer for the home service industry.
How much do you make doing what you do?
Right now, 60K.
Do you feel fairly compensated?
Yeah, I feel fairly compensated. It's a fun market, and I get to see the ins and outs of what they do. So you'd be surprised what a lot of people in, like, the blue collar industry do for fun. Just do to get their business out there.
How long have you been doing this?
About 3 years. I was under an apprenticeship for like 5 years before that.
How did you get into it?
I was working at a restaurant, and the guy I used to go to the gym with around the corner did stunt work. We both were filming something. He's like, hey, you want to come on film set? And I was like, yeah, all right. So I just jumped in, learned everything from him. Then he introduced me to somebody else who was bigger, and it just kept growing and growing.
What are some of the pros and cons of your job?
I would say networking yourself and getting the right network is important, because there's a lot of people that say they can deliver, but once you jump in, you're like, man, he did nothing. And you got to ask yourself if you really want to go to school or not, because the ups and downs of school is you'll get the network for the film industry, but for the outside, the real raw stuff, they're going to want to see examples. You're going to want to have to network with the right people. You got to prove it.
What pieces of advice would you share with anyone interested in doing your role or just in general? What have you learned?
Go to the big mastermind meetings and stuff like that, because you'll never know if they're, hey man, could you record me? I need it. Oh, that was much easier. It helps also connecting with other video producers that want to collab, because sometimes they don't want to collab. It's just being honest.
I'm a software engineer.
How long have you been doing it?
About 6 months now.
How much do you make?
I'm at $90,000 salary right now.
Do you feel fairly compensated?
Yes, I do. It's remote, so definitely feel fairly compensated.
What are the other pros and cons of your job?
My team is in Utah, so a big pro is like the diversity. People are also in California. There's a lot of diversity in the team. No cons, really. If anything, the time zone. I'm in a different time zone, so I wake up earlier and I get off earlier.
What kind of pieces of advice do you have for others interested in your role?
I would say you really have to have a passion for it. Don't just chase the money. You'll find a team. You'll find a job. As long as you love it, you'll have a great time.
What are your thoughts on a certification versus a college degree?
I personally had a college degree, so I don't know if I could recommend either or, but I definitely say a college degree prepared me. You definitely get so much more prepared in the field rather than what you learn online.
Step into Wix Studio, perspective, the new web creation platform.
Perspective.
This is Hannah Williams from...
But, you know, as I was saying, it definitely gives you a better understanding of kind of what that feel is for the market and what the industry is. A lot of people, I feel like, don't take the time to really understand what it is. So it's good to see that you have real authentic interviews coming out, and I'm excited to see how they're going to pan out in the future. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. I'm going to be cutting clips from here, making some shorts. Really good to see this new wave and some great content coming on to the YouTube space. Finally got a new mic, rocking the Rode pod mic. So really excited to see more reaction videos. Let me know what you think. Follow us at The Emphatic Truth. And as always, be blessed.